April 19, 2015, people. Good morning. We're going to discuss tyranny and tyrants. We're going to discuss social engineering by secret societies that have developed within the last portion of this age. We've already established that what the world is under is a big show that Lucifer, the morning star light bearer, prince of the air, would be given dominion for a time over this planet. I think I also mentioned in one of my videos to go back into the Ayavasi Mets, because it talks about the Kilian or the Kroni or the Venisam as a portion, the sixth portion of this evil being being able to manifest, and this sixth portion of him would be destroyed. Now mind you, the sixth portion of the Kalyan does not have to be just one being. This being has, and this is Vedic and Hindu mythologies that I'm speaking right now to you about. This being does not have to be one person. It could be collaborated or colossal thing that can make itself into 1,000 parts at this, in this kaliyuga. Now you understand, before in the yugas it came as two beings. And all this was allowed to happen, and this being is given a chance to repent. But if not, this oligarch, because that's what it has created now, an oligarch of secret societies trying to rebuild an Atlantis of technology, corporations, and it is considered a war machine. Now, if there is going to be a World War III, or this order out of chaos, this World War III is not going to be fought for a new world order like you think. It has already been written in the heavens, the true heavens, that if there is a World War III, it's because the abuse of planet Earth, and they tried to override God, and God allowed them to create a Bible, because God also knew someone would come along, or some people would come along and would figure out the deeper meanings of in the Bible, such as what the water symbolizes, such as what King Solomon is a Jedi. And I remember at 7, they had me watching. That was the first time I ever went to a movie, was to see Star Wars. Well, Star Wars has everything to do with a galactic enterprise that's being ran on this planet. An off-world enterprise. An empire. That has delved into secret rites and rituals to maintain this this power over this realm. I believe also that the chemtrails that we have here are not only to chemically harm us, but I believe the chemtrails are actually masking over other dimensional realms that has been accessed. There has been plenty of footage captured of beings like little fairies and gnomes and all this that have been captured on film in people's homes with their CCTV cameras. So that's letting me know that other worlds have come undone. And that footage is not a hoax. God of the cosmos has churned the cosmic ocean. The galactic center has been churned. So things are going to be out of order. He's taken back control of heaven and earth. That's their as below, as above, so below the doctrine of the oligarch tyrants. Now also there's people reporting that let me try to explain this too, because there's lots of people that have been talking about the Genesis 6 prophecy with the giants. Yes, they were giant races maybe 4,000, 5,000 years ago. But I think the giant races came about, some of them created monsters because they intermingled with humankind and weren't supposed to, but some giant races were just giant from the beginning because everything, like I said, was bigger, larger, at another level in existence. So we have, and I think what happened is they used that Babel Tower or whatever this thing was to access the CERN Hadron Collider, to access other dimensions, and these things came through here, came into Earth, and got stuck here. Could not go past some type of field that was created. And that's how they got stuck here and began to terrorize planet Earth. Because man has dominated man to his own injury. And a lot of angelics or angels have succumbed to this technology. So I'm proposing and saying that these chemtrails are really masking over or trying to create an atmosphere that can, it's really a debacle. This whole, whatever they've done has caused major problems. They're trying to solve one problem and have created another problem. That's what's really going on, people. And there won't be a new world order out of the chaos that they want to create. These secret societies on this planet, these bankers, these so-called bloodlines of the 13th bloodline, who have been going around looking for people with genetics that are considered a higher level of humanity, because that's what the Manus are about, and the Rishis. And that's the parentage of the true humanity, and they're trying to create a new type of human species. Now, is that God's will? I don't think God would operate in that type of secret occult society. Now, I done told y'all that the occult is, this is an occult crime. I got little John A awake now. Now hold up. So We have these beings. They are saying that some of these giants have put themselves in a stasis to awaken in the golden age, which I'm not too certain about that. Y'all can look into that, that they've went around capturing some of these beings, and these beings have to have been captured through other dimensional, through portals. You understand? They had the military has to have access to that to go into where these beings are and capture them. Now, for what reasons they've done it, I'm not certain yet. But I'm going to have to get off here now. I have someone awake, and I have to deal with them. Okay.